एवरीवन, सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज लीनियर इक्वेशंस एंड लीनियर इनइक्वालिटीज। सो फर्स्ट लेट अस नो व्हाट इज लीनियर इक्वेशंस। एन इक्वेशन कंटेनिंग ओनली वन वेरिएबल और लिटरल विथ हाईएस्ट पावर वन इज कॉल्ड लीनियर इक्वेशन इन दैट वेरिएबल। फॉर एग्जाम्पल 3x + 5 = 8, 3 - 2x = 5x, and 4n = 2/3, n - 1, etc. Now there are some rules for solving linear equations. First one, we can add the same number or expression to both sides of an equation. Second, we can subtract the same number or expression from both sides of an equation. Third, we can multiply both sides of an equation by the same non-zero number or expression. And the last one is, we can divide both sides of an equation by the same non-zero number or expression. So let us solve some more questions related to this chapter. The first question is, 2 whole 3 - 2x = 13. So for solving this one, what we have to do? First, we have to break the bracket. You must know the Bodmer's rule. So if you break the bracket, it will be 6 - 4x = 13. After that, since we have to find the value of x, we will try to transpose all the constants, or you can say number, on the other side. So we can write -4x = 13 - 6, or x = 7/-4. Or we can write it as -7/4. It will be the value of x. The second question is 21 - 3 - x/7 = x + 20. So to solve that, what we have to do, same thing, we have to follow the Bodmer's rule. That means we have to break the bracket. So we can write it as 21 - 3x + 21 = x + 20. Or since we have to find this x, what we will do, -3x, we will transpose this x on the left hand side, and we will transpose all the numbers on the right hand side. -x = 20 - 21 - 21. Or -4x = 20 - 42, or -4x = -22. We will eliminate this minus symbol. We can write x = 22/4. Or 11/2, or we can write 5 1/2. Next question is x + 1/5 - x - 7/2 = 1. So to solve that, first we have to take the LCM of 5 and 2. LCM of 5 and 2 that is it will be 10. After that we have to multiply the first term with 2 and second term with 5. Equal to 1, or we can write it as 2x plus 2 minus 5x plus 35 equal to 10. We will transpose this 10 on right hand side, so it will get multiplied with 1. The answer will be 10. After that we can write it as minus 3x equal to 10 minus 35 minus 2, or minus 3x is equal to minus 27. We will eliminate this minus symbol from both sides, or we can write it as x is equal to 27 by 3, or the value of x will be 9. Next question is x minus 4 by 7 minus x plus 4 by 5 equal to x plus 3 minus 7 by 7. So to solve this we need to find the LCM of left hand side first. So we can write it as LCM of 7 and 5 is 35. So we will do the same thing as we have done in previous question. That means we will multiply 5 with first term and we'll multiply 7 with second term by 35. Equal to x plus 3 by 7, or we can write it as 5x minus 20 minus 7x minus 28 equal to x plus 3 by 7 into 35. This 35 we will transpose on right hand side, it will get multiplied. So 7 5 ja 35, or we can write it as 5x minus 7x, we can write it as minus 2x, and minus 20 and minus 28 we can write minus 48 equal to 5x plus 15. We will take all the x term on the left hand side, so we will write minus 2x minus 5x is equal to 15 plus 48. Since 48 is minus here, when we will transpose on the right hand side it will become plus 48, or we can write it as minus 7x equal to 63, or x is equal to 63 by minus 7, and the answer will be minus 9. Next question is 3 multiplied with 2x minus 1 plus 25% of x is equal to 97. So to solve this one we will follow the Wollmer's rule. That means we will solve this term first. We can write 3 into 2x minus 1 plus 25 by 100 into x equal to 97. or we can write it as 6x minus 3 plus 1 by 4x equal to 97. Same, we will find the LCM. So we will get 4 into 6x minus 3 plus x by 4 equal to 97, or 24x minus 12 plus x equal to 97 into 4, or 25x equal to 388 plus 12, or x is equal to 400 by 25, or we can get the answer 16. Okay, you can do one more thing. In this step, you can take this minus 3 on this side, it will become 100. You can solve 6x plus 1 by 4x together. Okay, or you can write equal to 97 plus 3. This is also a method to solve this question. The next question is, a number is as much greater than 15 as it is less than 51. So find the number. So how we have to solve? Let the number be x. So as per the question, a number is greater than 15 and it is less than 51, then the equation will be x minus 15 equal to 51 minus x, or we can write it as x plus x is equal to 51 plus 15, or 2x is equal to 66, or x is equal to 66 by 2, that means 33. So the number is 33. The next question is, the sum of two numbers is 80 and the greater number exceeds twice the smaller number by 11. So find the number. So let the number be x. Let the number be x. So if one number is x and the sum of two numbers is 80, then we can say other number is 80 minus x. Okay, and it is given the greater number exceeds twice the smaller number by 11. So we can write x minus 2 into 80 minus x equal to 11, or x is x minus 160 plus 2x equal to 11, or 3x is equal to 11 plus 160, or 3x is equal to 171, and x is equal to 171 by 3, that means 57. So we have got the first number is 57, and the second number is 80 minus 57, that is 23. The next question is, इन अ क्लास ऑफ 35 स्टूडेंट्स द नंबर ऑफ गर्ल्स इज 2/5 ऑफ द नंबर ऑफ बॉयज, फाइंड द नंबर ऑफ गर्ल्स इन द क्लास. सो लेट द नंबर ऑफ बॉयज बी एक्स, लेट द नंबर ऑफ बॉयज बी एक्स. एंड इन द क्वेश्चन इट इज गिवेन द नंबर ऑफ गर्ल्स इज 2/5 ऑफ द नंबर ऑफ बॉयज. सो नंबर ऑफ गर्ल्स बी 2/5 ऑफ एक्स. द टोटल नंबर ऑफ स्टूडेंट इज 35. सो वी कैन राइट एक्स प्लस 2/5x इज इक्वल टू 35, और 5x प्लस 2x इक्वल टू 35 इंटू 5, और 7x इज इक्वल टू 35 इंटू 5, और x इज इक्वल टू 35 इंटू 5/7. So the value of x will be 25. Since we have got the number of boys, we have to find out the number of girls in the class. So number of girls is 2/5 into 25. That means 5 to the 10. Next question is, Aparna got rupees 27840 as her monthly salary and overtime. Her salary exceeds the overtime by rupees 16560. So what is her monthly salary? So let her monthly salary B X. Then overtime is equal to X minus 16560. So if you add both of them, you will get monthly salary. So we can write it as x plus x minus 16560 is both are equal to 27840, or you can write 2x equal to 27840 plus 16560, or 2x is equal to 444000, or x is equal to 444000/2. That means 22,200 is our monthly salary. Next question, after 12 years, I shall be 3 times as old as I was 4 years ago. Find my present age. So for this, let us take the present age be X. Present age be X. So after 12 years, age will be x plus 12. One part is given, 3 times as old was 4 years ago. So we can write x plus 12 is equal to, first we will write 4 years ago. That means x minus 4, ago means we have to subtract, and for 3 times we have to multiply. So by solving this bracket, we will get 3x minus 12, or we can write it as 3x minus x is equal to 12 plus 12, or x 2x equal to 24, or x is equal to 24 by 2, that means 12. So her present age is 12. Next question, the length of the rectangular plot is 6 meter less than thrice its breadth. Find the dimension of the plot if its perimeter is 148 meter. So breadth is not given, so let us assume, let breadth equal to x. So length will be 3x its breadth, that means 3x, and 6 meter less, that means minus 6. We know the formula of perimeter of the rectangle, that is 2 into length plus breadth. So we will write 2 into length plus breadth, and in the question the perimeter is given 148 meter. So by solving this bracket we will get 4x minus 6 equal to 148, or 8x minus 12 equal to 148, or 8x equal to 148 plus 12, or x is equal to 160 by 8. So the value of x, or you can say breadth, we have got 20 meter. Now we have to find the value of length. So the value of length, what we have to do, we have to put the value of x in this equation, that means 3 into 20 minus 6, 60 minus 6, it will be 54. So breadth is equal to 20 meter and length is equal to 54 meter. So I hope all these questions and explanation is clear to you. The topic linear equalities, I will make a separate video for that. So till then, keep practicing this question. Thank you.